Best smartphones for 2018. My pick of the very best phones for you. Also, don't forget to like, share, comment and subscribe for more informative and updated news on the world of tech. Here you can see the best smartphones for 2018. iPhone X. Is the iPhone X the best phone this year? Yes. But only by a whisker. The Samsung Galaxy S8 is so close, especially if you prefer Android, while Apple's own iPhone 8 Plus gives you so much of the iPhone X technology without the extra cost. In the end though, it's the ultra-desirability of the iPhone X that wins it. The first thing that strikes you about the design is, obviously, the 5.8-inch AMOLED screen. It's certainly true that the edge-to-edge screen looks absolutely stunning, both from a design perspective and from a technology viewpoint. Of course, there's also the top notch. This does intrude on the screen slightly, especially when you want to be fully immersed in something, but call me crazy, I kind of like it. It gives the phone a visual identity. Samsung Galaxy S8. The Samsung Galaxy S8 is the best Android smartphone in the world right now, boasting the brilliant Infinity Edge display which occupies 84% of the body and cutting-edge guts. Yep, this futuristic smartphone is a looker, and instantly made its competitors look dated. It's the next step in smartphone design. The S8 is the complete package, as well as the amazing display and industry-leading specs. This handset also has decent battery life, an excellent camera and amazing performance. With all of that combined, you get not only the best-looking smartphone, but one of the top-performing smartphones in the universe. Yes, the universe. Google Pixel 2 XL. We can't tell you how close it is between the Google Pixel 2 XL, iPhone X, and S8 for the title of best smartphone in the world. All three are great, but the sleek design, an amazing screen puts the iPhone and Samsung in the lead, just the Google Pixel 2 XL is still an amazing smartphone, especially if you prioritize camera quality and want software straight from Google. Whether it's the excellent camera, the metal and glass chassis, the oodles of power involved or just the fact that the software and virtual assistant work in perfect harmony with the hardware, Google's got a lot right here and this is a brilliant phone. 2017 was when Google came into its stride with the Pixel sequels. Google now has clear vision for its flagship smartphones. The design is distinctive and has character, and the Pixel 2 XL's edge-to-edge screen makes it the one to go for. OnePlus 5T. Looking to upset dominance by the big brands is OnePlus, who took the mobile world by storm in 2014 with one goal, to be the flagship killer. We think its latest smartphone, the OnePlus 5T, has finally achieved that goal. The OnePlus 5T gives you the latest smartphone trends, including an impressive 6-inch edge-to-edge display and dual camera setup with portrait mode. These new features are backed up by crazy powerful specs, a lightning-fast fingerprint sensor, and a genuinely premium design. Perhaps what's most impressive is that you'll get all of that for less than £500. iPhone 8 Plus. Here we have the iPhone 8 Plus, probably one of the most anticipated smartphones of the year. Some feel its sheer size does make it tricky to hold, but there's no denying Apple's beautiful 5.5-incher is a winner. If you prefer iOS to Android and don't want to splash out on the iPhone X, this should be your first choice. Apple has chosen to stick with a similar design to the iPhone 7, swapping out the all-metal case for a glass back and making it heavier, more premium feeling. There is a glorious new gold colorway available, and to top it off, the glass casing allows Apple to add wireless charging. The recent S8 design does make the iPhone 8 feel slightly dated now, however. HTC U11 Plus. The HTC U11 Plus is the most impressive smartphone HTC has made in many years. Taking the best bits from the U11 and combining it with a sexy edge-to-edge display, with a bit of extra innovation thrown in for good measure. It's again shown the rest of the competition how to make a premium smartphone, and its camera, battery life, and performance is right up there too. HTC has really worked on the criticisms of the previous generation devices, and created their best ever flagship smartphone, Huawei Mate 10 Pro. The Huawei Mate 10 Pro is the latest flagship from the Chinese smartphone giant, and we really, really like it. It's the ideal smartphone if you need a powerhouse for business, but it's also got plenty of features which make it great as a personal device as well. We love the Mate 10 Pro's Leica branded dual camera, which can capture some very pleasing images, and the OS is coming on leaps and bounds as well. One of the coolest features packed into the device is mobile PC experience when you hook up it to an external display. It only needs a USB-C to HDMI cable, rather than powered dock, making it more portable and as a result, immeasurably more useful. LG G6. LG has finally made a good-looking, premium smartphone free from gimmicks. There are a lot of features we love here. That wide-angle screen is great, the bezels are tiny, and the dual camera is really handy. Basically, we really enjoyed using it. But it's far from a perfect phone. LG has used a 2016 chipset, so it's not the most efficient smartphone available, and the skin over Android Nougat isn't the best out there. It also feels less premium than its rivals, with a slightly hollow feel to the rear casing. Certainly though, LG has done enough to redeem itself from the unfortunately unsuccessful G5 last year. It wasn't the best Android phone released in 2017, but we don't think you'll regret buying it, especially if you can pick it up for a decent price. Honor View 10. If you disregard the price, the Honor View 10 is a good smartphone. It has a solid design, decent camera, and high-end specs. It's essentially the Huawei Mate 10 Pro. But when you take the price into consideration, it becomes the bargain of the century. There are a lot of neat touches, too. We especially like the single navigation key, and the dual camera is capable of taking some striking images. iPhone SE. Notice how all of these smartphones have 5+-inch screens? What if you have small hands? You can't reach all four corners of the screen. It's a problem not many of us face, but the truth is some people just prefer smaller phones but don't want to sacrifice high-end specs. The iPhone SE is for you. With a 4-inch screen and guts which match the iPhone SIXS, including the 12MP rear camera, 2GB RAM, Apple Pay, Retina display, and Apple A9 chipset, this thing is a little pocket rocket. Motorola Moto Z2 Force. The Moto Z2 Force is a refreshing phone. It's both designed to be sleek and sophisticated, as well as durable with the ability to survive a beating. That's mainly down to the screen, which features a thick, toughened outer layer which won't break, no matter how hard you try. The casing is also pretty rugged, with a strong aluminium skeleton. The Moto Z2 Force doesn't look like it belongs in a workman's tool bag. The specs are up there with every other device on this list, and the ecosystem of Moto Mods is impressive too.